Messiah, walked on water, what else, peace.
Peace. Yeah. Messiah, walk on water, and peace. Yeah. From Somalia, Omar, would you be a Muslim man?
Yes, I am a Muslim, yeah.
Am I correct saying Isa?
Isa, yep.
Yep. Isa is the Messiah?
Isa is the Messiah.
And what does Messiah mean?
Saviour.
And you said walk on water. Can you elaborate? We're out here today on the water, Riverway.
Yeah, there's a lot of stories on that. Obviously, when I was studying, we used to do something called CRE, Christian Religious Education. So even if you were not a believer in Christianity, it was essentially a subject. So when we were learning this from the Christian faith, I'm not sure about the Muslim faith, but the Christian faith, Jesus walked on water. So that's pretty much where I got that from.
Omar, do you personally believe that that's a historical fact?
Mate, anything is possible.
Amen.
I do believe in miracles, and I do believe that Isa alayhi salam was a really... God gifted him with a lot of stuff. There was a lot of miracles. He talked when he was young, very young, like a baby. That I believe in, but I'm not going to objectify it to other people or, you know, force it on them. But I do believe that, you know, they are miracles, and I'm not sure if he walked on water or not, but if he did, I would believe it. There's nothing for me to say he didn't walk on water.
Can you show the people at home today how you can walk on water? I'm just kidding, Omar.
I can't do that.
All right. The last one you said with word association was peace. Now, out of the words that come up from the mind and the heart, when it came to Jesus, one of those words was peace. I mean, that's a formidable word. That's quite... What made you say peace?
Because from the teachings of... when I was growing up, I'm lucky enough to experience both secular education and religious education. So... From what I know from Isa or Jesus, he preached the message of peace. He brought people together, you know, harmony, peace, loving. I associate all those words with Jesus, whatever you want to call him, Jesus, Isa, Yeshua, whatever, you know. I don't really. So that's, you know, there's no negativity in that name unless other people put it in there, you know. But that's what I essentially believe in.
Have you put your trust in Jesus?
I trust in his maker, in Jesus' maker.
Who is Jesus' maker?
God.
The Alpha and the Omega?
Yeah, yeah. There's nothing, there was nothing before him, there's nothing after him. You know, you can say Alpha and Omega, yeah.
What does Christians say you have to be born again?
I believe that's when Christians believe that God... believe that they'll be saved because of believing that Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior, and then admitting that they're sinful or they were born sinners or something, and then you essentially give yourself to God or the Trinity or Jesus Christ and everything.
It says in a passage that as we are at Riverway here today, it says you actually have to be born of the water and of the Spirit. Have you heard those words before?
I haven't heard those words.
Well, what does it mean? And this is Jesus speaking, the word association, when it says to be born of the water and the born of the Spirit. Is that to do with baptism or the Holy Ghost? Or what would that be about?
Born of the
and
water.
And thank you, Omar, for sharing.
No worries. Born of the water and the Spirit. Mate, I have... I don't have any particular knowledge on that, but if I had to guess, I'd say it's because of baptism, born of the water. I think because Christians that I know have been baptized. I don't know if they're Catholic or whatever they are, but I think that's born from the water. I associate that with baptism, so that's pretty much it.
Omar, have you been baptized by water?
No, I'm not Christian.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Have you read the Quran in its entirety?
Yes, I have. But I haven't memorized it. You know, there's a lot of words in there. So there's a lot of passages, there's a lot of verses.
Do you have a favorite surah?
I do have a favorite surah, the first surah.
The first surah.
Yeah.
Can you elaborate just a little bit on that?
So it says, the first surah is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So
is that Arabic?
Yeah, that is Arabic. So that's thanking God, the world of the universes, essentially. So so there's always someone looking at, you know, down on you and protecting you and guiding you to the right path. He's everywhere with us, and that's what I really believe in my heart. And it's a really good surah.
This Jesus, just to wrap it up, this Jesus, it's interesting. You know him by three names, Jesus, Isa, and Yeshua. Yeshua's the Jewish name?
I think that's the Jewish, yeah. There's a lot of names for Jesus.
And the last word for the segment was peace. Have you heard that he's been called the Prince of Peace?
I haven't heard that.
There's a scripture in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. It says, For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government, which was one of your first words, and the government shall be upon his shoulders. And he shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Now that scripture is talking about Jesus, and it says he'll be the Eternal Father, the Prince of Peace. Is Jesus the Father and the Son? Or are they separate?
Obviously, I'm not a Christian. I'm a Muslim. But from a Christian's perspective, I would say there's the Trinity, God, yeah. Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. So there's three in one, essentially. And I think that's pretty much sums it up. Everything that all the names that was associated to Jesus essentially is three in one. So it's God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. So I think that's the way that Christians look at it from a Christian point of view.
Have you read the New Testament of the Holy Bible?
I haven't. I think I might have read it some time ago when I was studying for it, you know, when I was doing my exams and that, with the subject that I was studying about, Christian religious education. So I think that's pretty much as much as I know about Christianity. It's more than a lot of people know, but I don't know a lot into it.
Okay, we're talking with Omar this morning. Three words of word association. We've had soldier, we've had homosexuality, and we've had Jesus. All three subjects can be found in the New Testament Bible. And also read also in the Quran, those three subjects, soldier, homosexuality, and Jesus, they can all be found in the Quran. Is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
That is correct?
Jesus, homosexuality, and what was it? What was it again?
Soldier.
Yes, they are found in there.
And we had the last with the Prince of Peace. Well, thank you, Omar, for speaking to me from Somalia. Thank you for your time, and God bless. Thank you.